What has upset you?
Nothing, Mother. Please.
Tell me, darling.
I swept up all the leaves and no one noticed. No one thanked me. I do my best to help, but nothing I do makes an impression. They're all ungrateful.
Leaves. Yes, you did a very nice job raking them up, but you shouldn't be lifting rakes.
Oh, now you turn on me.
There you are, dearest. Why did you run off? Were you crying?
No.
The leaves don't see she raked them up. It would be a shame having your wife in her condition lift and tote like a day laborer.
Don't blame him. He doesn't know any better.
I apologize to everyone. Forgive me. Forgive me. There now. It's settled. It's all settled. Here. I brought you a chocolate wrapped in gold. She eats all the time. She has such cravings. Now about these leaves. I'll sweep them up.
I've done them all. They're raked. No one else thought of it but me. The wedding's tomorrow, and I'm the only one who thought about the leaves.
Have we heard anything further from the groom?
No word, I'm afraid.
He's probably not coming, dog. I kill myself over these leaves, and the leaves are screaming at the altar.
Don't be melodramatic. He's coming, I'm sure he's coming.
What makes you sure?
It's such a terrible match.
You'll get no arguments there. And I am forced to say, Reverend Lawrence is a ridiculous-looking man. I have restrained myself from patting him for luck on the head like a hunchback.
Don't be wicked. I don't like you when you're wicked.
You'd like me if I stopped this wedding.
How'd you do that?
Wickedly.
They're coming. The Reverend Pandora. Shh.
Dear Reverend Mother, the trellis will be wet.
A beautiful spot.
Red roses go all through the vine. After the ceremony, everyone will throw scarlet petals in our path. Mama's upset because the groom's late. She thinks he's not coming.
No, no, he's coming. I'm sure of it. His son's arrived.
Oh, which son?
Sydney.
How wonderful. Ever since the divorce, none of Edward's children have spoken to him.
Please, I'd rather we didn't mention the scandal.
Yes, no.
Shh. It's all secret.
Lovely day.
Yes.
Gentle breeze. I see. Congratulations are in order.
What?
I see you're expecting. Congratulations.
Is it really that apparent? I'm carrying extremely small for my size. I wasn't aware my condition was noteworthy.
Give me.
No, no, we're very proud, very pleased. We've dreamed of this ever since the day we were wed.
Yes.
We had the perfect wedding.
Yes.
The day was perfect.
I was happy.
Everyone was transformed by our love. It was effortless.
I'm going to wear blue wings for my wedding.
Really?
Edward once asked me what gift I would like most in all the world, and I told him blue wings. He put it in his book that I said that. It's something I really said, and he put it in his book. I am the girl in his book. No one but Edward has ever understood me.
Reverend, how was Nigeria?
Much squalor, much sadness.
You're such a good man.
Oh, I'm afraid I'm not. I'm not. But I thank you for the thought.
You are good, really.
Very good, in my book. Mm.
Shall we go in and have some refreshments?
Yes.
All right.
Reverend, have you ever been married?
Yes. I mean, no.
Pandora, wait a moment. I have something. Oh, let them go. Let them get out of range.
What is it?
I love you.
Yes, I love you too.
I wanted you to know that in case you had any doubts. And having said that, I must ask you, why are you marrying this man?
He divorced his wife of 23 years and all of his children just for me.
Ask yourself ponderously, what does that speak of his character?
Well, his character's not important. He's an artist.
So you have no doubts about your future? No gnawing concerns. I mean, the fact that he is over twice your age, myopic, rumored to be a drunkard, decidedly a philanderer, and has been known to wear a ponytail makes no matter to you.
Not really, no.
Farewell, as you wish.
Thank you, but you mustn't be concerned. He's everything I've ever wanted. All my heart desires, I
You're going to be his nursemaid.
I'm too young to be a nursemaid.
And yet it's your fate.
Oh, help me. You're my older sister. Please save me. Make everything all right again. I'm too young for all this.
All right. I'll do it. I'll break it off for you.
He's going to be so angry.
So he shall be. You must not sacrifice your life to some doddering old relic simply because he turned you into a silly legend.
I like being a legend.
Is it worth a bad marriage?
You've a bad marriage.
What makes you say that? Jonesy and I are very happy.
You seem to despise him. Yesterday, you and I were going out to get malts. Jonesy asked to join us, and you changed your mind immediately, saying you had no interest in a malt. When we returned with our malts, you cried and said you had wanted one all along. Jonesy offered you his, but you shoved it away with such force that it fell and splattered all over the cobblestones.
I suppose I simply did not want a malt after all. You don't understand being pregnant. There are cravings you can't explain, and these cravings run very deep. Reason does not speak to them. Now, shall I call off his wedding or not?
What do you think I should do?
Why ask me? It's your decision entirely. This will make or break your life, and I will not be held responsible. Yeah. Only you can decide.
I don't know. Why ask me? Let's pull the petals from this flower.
That is a childish way to make up your mind. A foolish solution.
I think it'd be fun to do it this way.
Fine, it's your life.
Yes, I'll marry. No, I'll not. Yes, I'll marry.
No, it stopped.
Fine.
But my heart. Too late. Live by the flower, die by the flower.
The wedding is off.
Refreshments are being served.
Mother, Pandora wants to tell you something.
What?
There'll be no wedding.
Really?
Yes, she's right. She's right. He's repulsive. I never should have agreed to marry such a hairy old goat. After all, the flower would have told me the truth.
There will be no marriage. The marriage is off.
What must we do?
Pick up the wedding cake.
Me. I refuse to have the whole town viewing it as an emblem of our impetuous hearts.
Oh, I'll come with you. I want to see all the roses and swirls and turtle doves.
Are you very unhappy?
No. I'm very happy. Very, very happy indeed.
Well, there's my good deed for the day. How it worries me. How it has me worried.
Ah, four. Mr. Edvard Munt has finally arrived. Where's Pandora?
She's breaking off the engagement.
But why?
Obvious reasons.
How shocking.
Bring him to me at once. I must explain the unfortunate situation.
Pandora's left it to you to break her engagement to this man?
An unpleasant chore, but I'll manage.
Did I tell you I loved you today?
Yes.
Tonight I'll pour sweet oils for your bath and rub your belly and feet. My wife, my cherished mother-to-be.
Please bring him.
I love you, my love.
I love you, I love you, I love you too. All this waiting.
Edvard Munt, I'm here in search of Pandora. I'm very late.
It's so nice to meet you. My name's Flora Whitman. I'm Pandora's sister.
Yes, well, you must forgive me. I was an hotel fire. My cat was burnt, my documents destroyed. I thought of calling first, but I'd have missed the next flight and been even later.
Don't worry, it's never too late to do what's right. Don't you agree?
No, I do not. As a matter of fact, I believe we're defined by the things we can no longer feel, dream, or accomplish. The man no longer capable of scaling the mountain. Quite different from the young boy who has yet to try. Indeed, if it were never too late to do anything, life would hold no meaning whatsoever.
Life hold no meaning? There are schools of thought that adhere to that philosophy.
A gravely unimaginative conclusion to these mysteries we behold. I adamantly reject the notion of meaningless existence.
Famous people generally do. Otherwise, the value of their fame would evaporate.
Well, it's true. Fame does help give meaning to life. In fact, fame helps a good deal.
On the other hand, I find it untragic that I've never done anything of use with my life. A big waste it's been. But that's not unusual. Most of us, most people, are in that boat. It's a very full vessel. I'm afloat with a mob.
Well, I don't know you. I can't say. You are having a child.
Another passenger on board.
You have a way of looking at things.
How kind you are and how polite. Now, did it ever occur to you my sister may be far too young for you?
No. I love her madly. What else matters?
That she comply. You'll forgive me for being rude, blunt, and the bearer of bad news. And I tell you, Pandora wants to call off the marriage. She feels it was a hasty decision and has decided against it firmly.
Are you serious?
Quite.
Well, where is she? I must speak with her.
Oh, she never wants to see you again.
No, I can't. It's too awful. Pandora! 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 Where is she? Pandora! My love, my life! Pandora!
Edward, you go, my lover! I missed you, Alfred. You never come.
Please don't toy with me. It's too awful. I'm too old.
Oh, no, don't cry. Don't cry. You mustn't.
Your sister says you're having doubts about the wedding.
Just some jitters, nothing of any matter. She doesn't know me. How can she tell what's in my heart? Look how he's crying. Aren't you ashamed?
I have disgraced myself for you and forced her as my sister.
She's very jealous of me. What can I do? Everyone says I'm the beauty and she's the plain one. Oh. Where have you been? Why are you so late?
I was in a hotel fire. My cat was burnt. My documents destroyed.
Oh, I love the sound of your voice. Come, let me kiss your tears away. Such a wicked sister I have.
She threw herself out of the moving car when she heard him shout her name.
Pity she didn't break her neck.
Please, you have to be happy for her now when she gets married, and sad for her later when she is married.
Divorce is an option.
People in our family don't get divorced. There's no precedent. Besides, a divorce would be so vulgar.
Yes. True.
If only he'd die soon.
I must say, he looks even older in person.
Really? Oh, my.
Good afternoon.
Hello, Sydney.
I heard my father has arrived.
Yes, he has. We're all so thrilled about the wedding.
Marriage is an evenly antiquated institution. A suffocating environment where banality is bred.
So many opinions and yet so young.
Indeed.
Tell me, Sydney, what of love? Do you regard love?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. Love has yet to avail itself to my scrutiny.
There's been no one?
In fact, no, not really. Well, there was this one girl I liked. We used to chat and talk about ice cream selection. She worked behind the counter and would offer me unlimited free samples in small midget spoons. Often I couldn't make a decision or up my mind and would ask for her recommendation, her preference. I would put it to her like this: which flavor would you get? I always enjoyed whatever she selected or chose until one day she picked pistachio. I wasn't pleased with it. It wasn't up my alley. I told her this, and she gave me a new cone, the Rocky Road. She took the pistachio from me, threw it in a canister, and said I was not to pay her for it. I knew she couldn't be giving away free cones. I was aware the price of the second cone would be deducted from her small wages. So I left money for it. The cone. Too much money, really, but I could not stand to wait for change. I never came back, of course, because it may have been an uncomfortable situation. Anyway, it could never have been the same.
This is a silly person.
I didn't know you were listening.
I'm not opposed. Mama, get a gun.
Let's go find your father, see if he'll say no.
Very well, except he doesn't want to see me.
Please, then why come?
I have a message for him.
What message?
A private message.
God, I never would have given you a free ice cream cone.
Please, Floral, try to be gracious. Let's go find your father. I'm sure he'll be delighted.
I'll just stay here and picket my wards.
Lovely. There are allowances you make for women in her position.
Undulations?
Laurel.
Reverend.
I...
But?
I'm so happy for you.
And I for you.
Me.
A great trip you've had.
Something of a pilgrimage.
And all this time I've not missed you.
You've been very busy.
Not least. Not a thing has happened. Not a thing.
Your sister's marriage.
Oh, I cannot be held responsible.
She professes deep love.
Meaningless protestations. Vaporous vows.
Sincerity is difficult to discern.
I'm in complete agreement.
Kind of you to say.
I hope you don't mind. I have so many things to do.
I'm terribly sorry to be late.
Not at all. We're just so thrilled about the wedding. And isn't it wonderful that Sydney has come all this way?
Sydney, yes. Pleasure to meet you.
We've met before.
Have we? Yes, I recognize the place very well. Tell me, where did we meet exactly?
My name is Sydney. I am your eldest son. You are my father.
Sydney? No, no, no. You're far too old.
Well, nevertheless, be that as it may, I am Sydney Raymond Lunt, your eldest son.
Well, your face is different. Your voice has changed.
Perhaps he had a growth spurt.
Yes, at one time he was much younger. It's just that there were so many offspring altogether.
Seven.
Well, I exaggerate. It's my temperament. Well, I'm very glad that you've come after all. Very pleased indeed. I was afraid that you children weren't speaking to me.
We're not. I've come only to deliver something to you from Mother.
Well, as long as it's not a poison cloak for Pandora. Well, what is it?
I prefer to give it in private.
Oh. I'm off to pick up the cake. Pandora, please come, sister.
Reverend, let me show you where the cardinals gather in the grove.
So, you're Sydney, my son?
Yes.
Amazing what time does.
Yes.
Remember my reading Lament to you?
No.
I did for a while. Every night when we lived in Pittsburgh.
We left Pittsburgh when I was two.
Too young to remember?
I don't know. In any case, I don't.
Well, you should read it sometime. It's actually an excellent poem.
I'll look it up.
Do.
Mother sent this note to you.
The way she writes, so small and blunt, workmanlike, no curlicues, and with a pencil. This simple, terrible handwriting touches me to the heart.
Do you see what she says?
What does she say?
She's going to kill herself if you marry Pandora. I'm to let her know as soon as the vows are exchanged, and then she's throwing herself out of the attic window.
She's not serious.
She clawed her face with a nail. She'll do anything.
I cannot hear this.
Please do not force Mamay to jump from the attic. I could not live without her because of how I love her.
God.
What are you thinking?
I wish you loved me the way you love her.
You hardly ever live with us. It's been years since we've spoken.
I don't know what to say to children.
Of course. It's not your fault. Please don't make my mother die.
I don't know what to do. Dark veil descends over the proceedings. If I call off the marriage, I'll be the victim of a coarse and scurrilous blackmail worthy of Pandora's eternal scorn. And yet if I marry, Margaret will kill herself. How can I live with her blood caked all over our wedding vows? What am I to be, a coward or a killer? God, what an impossible way to start a marriage! Hand me that letter, I must see it one more time. Oh, how I am tormented by this measly handwriting. Don't tell Pandora. Tell no one. I must bear the burden alone.
I'll bear it with you.
What can you do? You're no help. Go away from me with your beard and your glasses. I pray I never grow as old as you.
There were three cardinals in the grove. Bright red they were, and in high spirits.
I spoke with my father.
Nice to have a living father. My father's been dead for 27 years.
My father's a good man. Only he doesn't know what to say to children.
It was a boating accident. I watched him drown. You never really get over that shock. That shock of losing a parent.
I'm dancing in the night. Everything's in bloom, and I'm dancing in the night. All alone. Out here. Come look at me. Everyone. I'm dancing all alone. I'm spinning under all of these stars, and I can't stop. I will not stop. No one can ever make me stop. Never, never. Where is my lover?
I cannot see.
They're coming. Don't trip. Mr. Love, watch yourself.
A reverend will bring candelabra. The light. I wonder if I got these boys out here touching bronze.
Oh, how lovely. What a vision you make.
I don't have the urge. I've just been eating too much.
I'll dance with you.
Oh, jump me! Jonesy is the most wonderful dancer in the county. All the women seek his company. He's acclaimed.
Yes.
here. Let's remove these shoes. I'll massage your precious feet.
Oh, look at me. I can't stop spinning. Oh, hold me in your arms before I lose myself altogether. Where's the music? Wasn't there a music playing? Violins, harps, string instruments?
There's no music out there.
But I heard it so clearly. Could it have been in my head? All in my head? How flustered I am with excitement. Tomorrow I will be wed. Tonight is the last night I stand on this planet, a solitary person. I'll never be alone again. Marriage is the most wonderful state, never to be alone.
I've never been lonely a moment since the day I said I do. Not one instant.
All this love, it will last and last and last.
Yes.
Not necessarily. My first marriage didn't last forever.
But it wasn't a good marriage.
For a time it was. In the end it fell apart. I met you.
We brought the candelabra. I found kind assistance.
Ah, Sydney, where have you been?
I thought it best to keep my own counsel.
You missed supper. Pheasant was served.
And a package of peanuts that was given to me on the plane.
Would you like the candelabra?
Right here, please. Thank you.
Something terribly sad about the way this evening's proceeding.
What's sad? Tell me.
It's not something one can explain. It's very sad indeed.
Now for the primrose oil. A special blend all my own.
Have you hurt your foot?
Not in the least. He does this regularly.
Oh. Have you given further consideration?
Don't plague me. Enough.
Magnificent candelabra. Mood created.
I feel like the girl Edvard wrote about in his book, brimming with sadness and longing under flickering lights.
You mean Sandra in The Zookeeper?
Yes.
Well, I suppose I'm not literary. Although I am a voracious reader, psychologically astute, and a keen observer of human behavior. Still, I don't see the likeness. The girl in the book, she had a job. She feeds the animals at the zoo.
Yes.
Well, Pandora, as most of us know, has never had a job of any sort. The only pet she ever had was a bowl of 5 unfortunate goldfish. The largest swiftly starved to death because she never fed them. When I requested she remove its rancid carcass, she refused in a state of high hysteria. The remaining fish swiftly perished, and the stench permeated our entire property, and only then was she finally forced by the household to flush the malodorous mess down the sewer.
I could not understand why I should throw out a fish because it was dead. It had done nothing wrong or unnatural. I still loved it. It was still my fish. Why should I toss it down the drain?
Because it stank.
Listen to her. Her heart is bigger than all of ours together. And she teaches me so much. I thought my life was over when I met you.
Oh. What does this mean? Tell me.
She's my bride.
What are you saying?
She's my bride for better or for worse.
Is that your final answer?
Oh.
Do you understand what this means?
Your mother makes her own decisions. I cannot be held responsible.
It's only because she loves you that she is killing herself.
Who's killing herself? Let's have dessert.
My wife has threatened to jump to her death the moment our wedding vows are exchanged.
Your marriage to me will kill her?
Only if she's crazy. And only if she's told.
I do not like scandal. I will not invite it into my garden.
Forgive me. I did not want the situation revealed. I knew it would cast a shadow. Yet it's unavoidable how truth seeps out of its hole and crawls toward the light.
It certainly is not unavoidable. I've never heard of such a thing.
Now you must love me to go through with our marriage under such tragic duress.
Just so you'll know, after Mamay kills herself, I plan to take my own life with an unsharpened hatchet. I feel certain my fellow brothers and and sisters will follow suit and do the same.
No. I will not have a scandal of this magnitude in my garden. What a pity. The wedding is called off.
No, Mama, please. Everything is prepared to break my heart. The whole town will whisper I've been jilted. Think of the shame.
Reverend, advise us swiftly. Give us your wisdom.
I have so little.
Don't dally with me. This is your vocation.
I believe you must seek to be with those you love and of whom you are beloved.
At any price? A whole family slaughtered?
Slaughter yourself in any sense is a sin. We must find love in our hearts, no matter how meager the supply.
How grateful I am to have forsaken organized religion of any sort.
Mama, I want to have my wedding.
Let's wait a bit. We'll wait.
Oh, it's mid-May. Everything's in bloom. We can't wait. Now is the time. If we must, we'll run off tonight and I'll never see you or speak to you again. How I will miss you.
Pandora, don't do this to me.
Don't make me, I beg you. Do not make me.
Very well. The wedding will proceed as planned.
Yay!
Then all must die.
Thank you, Mama. We're going to be happier than anyone has ever been in all the world.
More champagne, please.
Except perhaps for you and Daddy. My parents were very, very happy, weren't you?
We were.
And Josie and I are very much in love. We're having a child together. Our first child. Tonight, we'll pick a name. One for a boy and one for a girl.
Floral.
What?
To hear you speak of the child. Our child. You hardly ever do.
Why illuminate the obvious? Look at me. I'm gigantic. Elephantine, even. Choo, 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 choo. What? I could accommodate a circus under this tent.
I believe she could.
Three rings at least.
I don't doubt your prowess in the slightest.
Nor should you.
Excuse me.
Reverend, where are you going?
Off.
What for?
To pray.
He's such a very good man.
Everyone isn't always as they seem.
What do you mean?
Everything isn't always as pictured. Frankly, I'm carrying around a huge empty frame with no walls to hang it on. A rectangle of steel. It weighs 2,000 tons. My back aches, my shoulders burn, and even though it's empty, the damn thing is heavy. As usual, no one knows what I'm talking about. We're just waiting for the noise to stop. I'm gonna go roll down a hill. Can anyone understand that?
Oh, you're forgetting your shoes.
My feet will no longer fit in them.
Oh, her mood swing. Her condition. Our dessert is long overdue. Sherry's Jubilee. I'll retrieve it from the pantry.
Oh, wait, Mama, I'll come with you. You'll need me.
What do you mean?
You'll see.
See, I don't want to see. I don't want another surprise again for the rest of my life.
A fine night.
Yes.
Glorious weather. I have been wondering. Is it yours?
What?
The child Floral is carrying.
Excuse me?
I beg your pardon. My mind plays tricks. I'm a very handsome man.
Why would you make such a remark?
I don't mean to boast. It's simply true. Don't you agree? I am handsome.
Yes, I suppose your face is well-structured.
Regrettably, sex holds no interest to me. It doesn't... doesn't even repulse me. I'm that flaccid, I'm afraid. And what makes it such a tragedy, which is my point, is the fact that I'm so very, very handsome.
I see.
I love Flora. I love her because she struggles so hard. But I have never had sex with her. Something is absent, that longing. I wrung her bath, massage her feet with oils, dab her wrists and neck with fine perfumes. I powder every crevice of her body. And feel only calm. I flirt with other women to proliferate the myth that I'm a cad. There are rumors of my prowess and endless adulteries, but nothing is ever revealed. There are no revelations to make. Nothing is hidden. All is illusion, misdirection, and palming.
Whose child is it?
I don't know.
What does your wife say?
We pretend it's mine.
How?
I don't know, but we do.
That's very terrible.
I thought it was admirable.
It's chilling.
We're talking about the same thing. We mean the same thing. We're just using different words. I feel like a stroll. Will you join me?
Actually, I'm very tired. I was in a hotel fire. My cat was burned. My documents destroyed.
Well, certainly, you must get your rest.
If you had asked me, I would have said impossible that I should live to see this day, a grown daughter of mine. Mr. Lunt, I'm mortified. Laurel has carved into your wedding cake.
She took a giant piece, leaving a lopsided mess.
I fear she must have eaten cake with her hands. Such grotesqueries. What have I raised? God, what have I raised?
It really is a small matter.
Not if your mind works in metaphor. A deliberate desecration.
Are you certain it was Flora?
I saw her after all. I watched her take it.
Did she eat it with her fingers?
Mother, tell me. He cannot give her the one gift she craves, so all others are fluke.
What gift does she crave?
Faithfulness.
How strange.
She went into counseling at the church. No one in our family had ever gone into counseling. There was no precedent. She had a session every week with the Reverend.
For a time, she seemed happy.
Then he left for Nigeria.
After which she got pregnant.
Or was it right before?
After.
Forgive me, I'm very tired.
His cat was burnt earlier today.
How dreadful.
Won't you come in now, Mama?
No. I just want to stay out here. Breathe some air.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, darling.
being in your line of vision.
Please, Sydney, don't be odd. Won't you come in and have some cherries, Jubilee?
Oh, I beg you, stop treating me kindly. I am not here as a friend of these proceedings. I've come only to destruct and annihilate.
In any case, you can still have Jubilee.
Forgive me, I cannot.
As you wish. You know, Sydney, we are not on opposite sides. I too would like nothing better than to see this engagement broken. Confidentially, I do not think the match to be at all suitable. Champagne?
I don't drink.
Why not?
I like to keep a clear head.
What for?
To deal with the day, my business. I'm not really clear on that.
Yes, I understand how confusing it all is, being rational.
Mind-boggling, really. Mm-hmm. Now that I've handed a thought and passed it a glance. And so, champagne, please. Well, this could, after all, be my last night on Earth. My last look at the moon.
Such a nice one.
Oh, and stars.
Glittering, glittering, glittering. All in all, a fine last night. Cheers.
Yes. Do you really think I'll be dead tomorrow?
Only if you have not a lot of common sense, then you prove to be a completely ludicrous person.
Well, I understand your ridicule, but every time I shut my eyes, I see...
What?
My mother's body falling. I could not live without my mother.
And yet you would.
How would I?
You would breathe.
Oh, yeah. Please. Breathing helps.
Sydney, I want to tell you something.
What?
It's a secret. Can you keep it?
Yes.
I'm not well anymore.
What?
Just that.
You're ill? How ill?
Very much.
Very much ill? Oh, I'm so sorry.
Fortunately, it's hopeless. There's more dignity that way. Don't you agree?
I don't understand. You look well.
Thank you. I make an effort.
Have you told your daughters?
I feared it would cast a shadow.
How can this be? I don't understand. You look so well. So very well. My heart has stopped. It stopped.
Breathe.
I cannot.
Breathe. My husband's buried. Both daughters married. Grandchild on the way. It's enough of a life, don't you think? What else is there to do? Endless travel? An old lady alone on a steamer? Draped in wool, watching the fog lift, drift by, sipping tea. Remembering what? My first kiss under the arbor. Heavens.
I love you.
You just kissed me on the lips. What in the world?
Forgive me. I'm a young. young upstart, worthy only of contempt, to be thoroughly despised, roundly horsewhipped.
No! No! Foolish, stupid boy, don't do that!
What have I done?
You've upset the fairy houses. Fairies live under toadstools. Now, we'll have no place to sleep. Now, come home and I'll be lost.
No one ever told me about the fairies. No one ever came to take my teeth.
What a dreadful night this has turned out to be.
I'm sorry I didn't know about them, the fairies. I would never have done it had I known. I have never meant to hurt anyone. Happened to you?
I've been rolling down hills. My heart has been dragged all through these woods, leaving a trail of red you can follow with your eyes closed because of the stench.
Flora, I'm so grateful to have come upon you. I have some information to impart. Nothing noteworthy, in fact, a matter of no importance to anyone. Yeah. I have come to the conclusion this evening that I must leave the church. It is not much, but it is all I have to sacrifice for my hypocrisy. I'm not a talented or impressive man. All I had to give the world was a few good deeds. I took the woman with no legs in Easter bonnet. I taught the blind child to sing. I allowed mosquitoes to suck my blood with impunity. All this was a desperate wish to have some value. And I betrayed it all. The meaning of my life. And the woman I esteem above all others, I beg for forgiveness. I do not expect it. In fact, I firmly believe forgiveness must never be granted. But I do crawl at your feet, on my hands and knees, now and always and forever.
Please, penitence is not necessary. Understand, I'm quite happy with my husband. We're having a family. All goes well. All is intact.
I am relieved and joyous to know that your spirit survived the evil I perpetrated. You came to me for guidance, and I carried you to iniquitous grounds.
Ridiculous man. I seduced you.
No, I seduced you.
You are quite incapable of seducing a harlot in Dante's Inferno.
Oh, I am. I most definitely am. I am not good at all.
No, you are good. And you must not leave the church, just as I must not leave my marriage.
No. You must not.
Why do you say that to me?
Because it is the right thing to say.
Is it? Is it?
Yes. It is.
Very well. Jonathan?
Yes? Or?
Jonathan. Oh. I feel romance all in the air. It's ripping through me like flowers blooming through my skin.
I cannot bear this.
Do something.
You are the man's wife.
I was before.
And now with his child.
There it is. You find me unpleasantly large.
No, I think you're very pleasant in shape. Really quite in total. I find your shape, my tongue has departed.
In bed, you are so different.
I spark fires.
Yes.
And All because of you. It would not be possible with anyone else.
Take me.
Where?
Wherever.
I have to go.
I will kill you.
Do. It would be a blessing.
How should I kill you?
However.
With my claws. My teeth. My body and soul.
Yes, yes, all that.
Till there's nothing but shreds.
I have to take you. There's no stopping me. This begins from this onerous affliction. I can't. I can't. This is impossible. Impossible.
Is it? Is it? I have never cared for you. I'm happily married. Happily, happily, happily. And my child will come from a good home. Without any hint of scandal. And everything will be possible for you. My dear. My most secret dear. All will be possible.
My God, I was looking for you.
I've been rolling downhill. Won't you bathe me, wash my hair, and soak me in fine scents? One emphasized accessories in the later stages of pregnancy. Is it too much?
It's perfect for the occasion.
I'm sorry I lurched into the wedding cake. I was so hungry I couldn't stop myself. There's no excuse, just an overwhelming craving I couldn't control.
Forgive me, I thought we were civilized human beings, not animals.
Where are you going?
Get the show on the road.
Good morning, Sydney.
Forgive me.
As you wish.
She can do so much with the tone of her voice. Why do you wear that awful beard?
My fresh face is gruesome to me. Innocence repulses me on every level. I can't watch children play in a schoolyard without experiencing revulsion.
Nonetheless, you should shave.
How can I, when under this growth is the despicable face of a pasty coward? After all, this morning, my father marries. My mother dies. That's simple. And I'm eating a muffin.
They are good, aren't they? May I have some?
Yes.
Now, in my opinion, if you were truly a man of character and loved your mother as you profess, you wouldn't sit here impotently eating a muffin. You would take action.
Well, what should I do?
Stop him! Shoot him, do something to slow him down.
Shoot my father?
To save your mother. If you don't have a pistol, there's one in the kitchen. He hidden in the yellow sideboard, bottom left-hand drawer beside the silver trivets.
All right. I'll go. It is my fate.
And bring more muffins. The ones with the raspberries. Whew. How will it end? I see no end. No end. Edvard Munch.
Yes.
Last night, there was a little misunderstanding between us that I must rectify. When I said there could be a circus performing under my skirts, I was implying it was meant to be a joke. You see, I was attempting to indicate I was wearing a tent, you know, a large billowy dress. Because of the pregnancy, I'm so big and wearing such large garb, i.e. tents, that a circus could or would be capable of performing underneath. Now you, I assumed I meant I could service a whole circus. I mean, an entire company of clowns and whatever could come up under my skirts with their lascivious little ladders and horns and party, 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 or whatever. Actually, it's a joke I could have phrased more carefully. Still, your interpretation was not warranted.
In attempting to follow your amorphous train of thought, I seem to have derailed.
In any case, I would like you to know, I'm extraordinarily particular about who I see privately. I'm no virgin, but other than that, I'm wholesome to the extreme. Having said that, I beg you to leave.
Can I leave? I'm to be married in 3 minutes.
You're in danger if you stay for this wedding.
Yes, yes, I have my doubts. I mean, I'm already suffocating in all this ceremonial paraphernalia. When Margaret and I wed, it was simple. Everyone brought a dish and danced without shoes.
You could be shocked.
No. In every sense, I shall keep my shoes on and be civilized.
Being civilized is a rot.
I disagree. Without the tormenting friction between the civilized and the primitive, life would be bereft of its most rapturous flavor.
And what flavor is that?
Erotic abandonment. For there can be no eroticism in a wholly primitive world, and no abandonment in a wholly civilized world.
Yes. Yes, I see. Table manners are important. So that when we eat berries with our fingers and let the juices drip down our lips, a statement is made.
You have a way of looking at things.
How kind you are and how polite. Now, to save your life, rush immediately to the train station, get on the first one that comes, and go wherever it takes you.
To be free of all marriages forever, I will go. No. I love her. I cannot. And yet...
More drama. The Reverend was not to be found this morning. Servants went to search for him across the property and discovered him in a ditch. His clothes had to be laundered. Kendall was very cross.
What was he doing in a ditch?
Crying is what I heard. I'm holding the rings. Pandora's here. I'll hold yours as well.
Yes, of course. Not here. I must have left it. I'll retrieve it at once.
I don't believe he'll be back.
Nonsense. They're very much in love. And a beautiful wedding is just what we all need today. Good day, Reverend.
Mr. Whitman.
The groom ran off. Nervous nanny. He forgot his ring. An odd fellow. I believe he's European. Or his family's European. Or he's been to Europe. Excuse me, I'm such a torrential bore. I don't know how my wife puts up with me. Oh, I've always preferred a few simple things. My estate, my yachts, my trusted staff and crew.
We're ready to begin.
is here.
The groom is absent.
You mean for good?
It was in my pocket all along, but not the pocket I thought, the wrong pocket.
Yes, naturally. Send here, hand me the ring.
Has anyone seen my son Sydney?
Shh, shh. The bride.
Dearly beloved.
Stand up, all of you! I'm going to shoot my father.
Heavens!
There will be no marriage. The marriage is off.
How mortifying. I am terribly sorry.
Everyone, except my father, will leave here at once.
Perhaps we should all go.
No, I won't leave you. Never, never.
Pandora, please.
Get away from him. Stay away.
Right about how I died protecting you with my blue wings.
Don't be so sure I won't blast those wings.
How dare you endanger these people? Hand me that gun, you ridiculous maniac!
Hold it!
You doubt for one instant I would not relish a bullet to the brain. But yet, the heart! Blast it to shreds! All to shreds!
You are mad. Be reasonable. I will shoot.
No! Sydney! If you shoot that reverend, I'll never speak to you again.
Candle! Please don't say that.
My God, he's been shot!
Yes, he has!
I'm such a failure, an abject failure!
Reverend, you saved us. You're such a very good man.
I don't know what to do. I'm bleeding. Help me! Reverend, help!
Don't ask me for help. I'm through giving help. Here, take this collar. Have it. More fit for a beast than a man. Sick from answering prayers and doing good deeds. It's turned me into a raving lunatic. It's left me with desperate, unquenchable desires. I want to spit on all altars the remainder of my days. God, I am wretched.
Someone help me.
You got what you deserved.
I cannot bear the sight of blood.
Oh, mercy. Mercy. Take him into the manor. Let the health physician tend those wounds.
Father!
When I was a windy boy and a bit in the black spit of the chapel fold inside the old ramrod,
dying of women, I tiptoed shy in the gooseberry wood.
The rood owl cried like a telltale tit.
Once you're married, you're stuck. Nothing ever changes. Every year there's a turkey at Thanksgiving and a goose at Christmas. Jonesy gives me one more letter opener for my collection, and no one ever sends me any mail. Tradition cements our sanity. But if I wanted things to be different, would it all change?
Are you saying you want a goose for Thanksgiving?
I'm saying this is not Jonesy's child. What should I do?
Don't tell Jonesy.
I haven't.
Good.
But I suspect he knows.
How?
We don't have sex.
Since when?
Ever.
Oh, dear. Here. Does he say?
wonderful mother. That all along he's always wanted a child and will have a beautiful happiness. Something. I don't know.
This is all good?
I don't love him.
Yes, I see. You have a lover.
No.
But you did.
Well, that woman.
What does he say about the child?
I've been told him it's his. He assumes it's Jonesy's.
Oh, dear. This really is quite a mess. And on your sister's wedding day. It reminds me of that time you got that horrid green gum stuck in your hair on confirmation day. Now you can't cut this one out with scissors and cover it with a wide-brim hat.
No.
Don't cry. Well, do if it helps.
Nothing helps. You see, all along, all I ever wanted was to emulate you and Father. How you loved each other.
We didn't love each other.
You always said you did.
That's because we didn't want you children to know how much we suffered. We didn't want you to get the wrong idea about marriage.
We might have gotten it all wrong.
I couldn't let that happen.
No. I love you, Mama.
I love you, too.
Tell me what to do.
Think of it like this. Eventually, we'll all be dead. Your travails will have ended, and you can rest in peace, knowing you have experienced pain, confusion, and various contretemps you've like girth.
What about the scandal?
It shall be monumental. All will be raked over coals and publicly crucified without mercy.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, who really gives a damn?
Mother, Ed Bog and I have decided not to be bullied and blackmailed by his deranged ex-spouse. We're driving over to Lord's Academy, where we will be wed at once by the Justice of the Peace, who awaits our arrival.
Darling, you are determined.
Yes, quite. And please do not suspect it is because I am in her woeful condition. I have no intention of ever having children. What they could do to you.
Yes, I know. I'm aware. How's Sydney?
A scratch, a flesh wound, nothing of note. He turned out to be entirely unremarkable.
Well, I think I'm going to go wrap up the top tier of your wedding cake so you can take it with you.
Oh, thank you, Mama. Oh, isn't it romantic? We're running off to be wed outside the arms of the church.
Along with some rose petals and champagne.
Oh, yes, 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 yes. What do you imagine happened to the Reverend? Such scandalous behavior.
Pandora.
Goodbye, Flora.
I love you.
I love you too.
Having said that, I must admit I am terribly jealous of you.
Of course you are.
I plotted against your wedding.
I know you have.
My marriage? It's a morbid predicament without passion or hope. You have such brave gaiety, romantic notions, youthful daring, and translucent beauty.
Yes, but there's a terror to it.
What terror?
I play the lovely, joyous child everyone adores and is drawn to, but sooner than later my face will be less round, my eyes will dull, worry lines will cross my heart and brow, and I'll become something that once was and now is not. My charms will not age well. Now is my time. I must take it.
My beloved, your car awaits.
Oh, yes, I'll gather my fallen bouquet. Oh, beautiful blue flowers.
Look at her. So pleased with the newness of the day. Like a brand new penny that's not yet been dropped in wishing wells. Toll booths or handed to beggars. Flipped for bets or used in bad magic tricks.
Jonesy dead!
Mademoiselle! And yet I have my doubts.
Who doesn't?
Many don't.
Hated multitudes.
Oh, your rings! I'm holding your rings!
Oh, give me, give me!
Pestilence and hope were in Pandora's box. Hope was the salvation. Or was it the final pestilence?
An argument for the ages.
What are they talking about?
Nonsense. Goodbye, Jonesy. Our rings don't lose. Goodbye, dear sister.
My most heartfelt congratulations to you both.
And Laura.
Farewell. Farewell. Auf Wiedersehen.
An odd man. He thought jasmine were honeysuckle.
I want to ask you a question.
Naturally, I wish them well and hope they have the most pleasant life. People deserve such things.
Your lovers? Which ones have been your lovers?
Floral, how strange.
Everybody knows about your infidelities. I've known for some time. I suspect even my mother suspects.
But I don't have lovers. Darling, you of all people must know. You know I cannot... It's quite clear I cannot...
With me?
With everyone.
I thought only me. You flirt with so many.
So they won't know, so you won't be ashamed.
My, all this time I thought it was only me.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I thought it was all apparent. I assumed you knew that my attention to others was merely a guise to make us appear normal.
No. I missed that.
Now you understand.
Yes.
Good.
I think I have to leave you.
No! Impossible! You're my wife! That's my child!
It's not!
We'll pretend it is! I'll love it like it is!
Love can't make it so.
What can?
It has to be.
I see. I see. There's... nothing I can do.
About what?
Anything. Everything. I give up. I surrender. Wrap me in a white flag and ship me towards death. Better than whining and wanting like an undignified dog, don't you agree?
Well, I do believe it's been your character.
Best not be without character.
People can change.
Who told you that? They were lying.
I've seen it happen.
Well, best believe your own eyes.
What are you thinking?
I'm trying to remember if you said anything clever yesterday. Something I could compliment you on today. So rarely do I look people in the eye and wonder what it is they are thinking. What if it was something that could spoil the day? Because what you are thinking is exactly the opposite of what I am thinking. It's diametrically opposed. That's not to say I believe you to be wrong and me to be right, or vice versa. Truthfully, my belief system is lenient to a grave degree. There is no point at which my spine is not wholly gelatinatized. And yet I'm so handsome.
Hello.
Sydney Lunt! I was just explaining to Floral why it is that we have such a bad marriage. You see, she snores. I've never really been able to abide it, that trait.
I've kept it to myself all these years, but it is something that has bothered me every day of my life, and I will no longer keep quiet about it. This is not to say, dearest wife, that I do not adore you in many other respects. But this grievance strikes a chord so deeply deep that I must insist we seek a divorce at once. Do you agree?
Yes. I agree.
Very good. You are our witness, Sydney? Good day.
I have your muffin.
Yes. Sydney, in retrospect, I must say the gun suggestion was a mistake.
No question. No question. However, I was able to call Mame and report that the wedding did not take place. She was quite happy. For the moment.
Hope.
Hello, Sydney. Laurel.
What has happened to you?
I have been rolling down hills, giving vigorous thought to the question. The question, what is impossible? The answer was a formidable lot. Dance from here to the stars. To eat. A tribe of bees. To scream down a forest. To remember when you were born. To know when you will die. To stop breathing and live. Many things are impossible. Endless things are impossible. Our life together is not quite that.
Not impossible?
Tricky, yes.
Jonathan, I must... Oh, must I speak the truth? Oh, I feel so I could perish. If only I would perish.
Please, don't perish, no.
Your child I'm carrying. I am in love with you. I want to be with you forever.
Impossible.
What will happen to us?
Many things. But not in this country.
Where?
Here. Here.
Sydney, you have made a shambles of the day.
I've behaved abominably, there's no doubt.
My children, my girls, little lives are just ruined.
Things do not look promising. Floral's just departed with the Reverend.
To seek counsel?
No. It seems, apparently, if I am not wholly mistaken, he's the father of her child.
Oh, I miss that. Is it too late for me to change?
Well, what would you change?
Change my life.
Yes. It's too late to change that.
All the rest? Well, the rest could be different.
I believe so.
Kiss me, Sydney.
Forgive me.
For what?
Well, you see, I am such an impossible fool.
I understand. I remember my first kiss. Way out in the garden under the arbor. I was 7. Boy was 9. He grabbed me by the puffs of my sleeves and pulled me to him.
kissed full on the mouth. I was terrified. I ran away. Afterwards, I felt so wicked. I was in a mood for days. At night, I'd lie in my bed and I'd think of my dark secrets, my heart pounding, my body trembling. I was all so quick and slow.
May I trouble you for one raspberry before I go?
Of course. I have plenty.